Hello everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough. We're going over to 4-4. Let's start. I don't think there's a secret exit in here, but this does branch off into two paths. One goes to the item house, the other one goes to the next stage, and how did I completely miss that pipe? Anyway, it's a swimming level! Woo! Choreographed fish swimming for the win! And, for some reason when you fry a fish, you get a coin. Usually, when you buy a fish fry, you have to pay for it, but in this case, you get fed for free as well as getting paid, so I'm not complaining whatsoever. There's surprise blooper attacks in these pipes. You can tell which angle they're gonna come out depending on which, wherever their top is pointed at. It's kind of like an arrow, actually, the way they're designed. That's probably the whole point of it, actually. And I got some spiky fish coming after me. Oh, lose the fish! Don't even bother with the red coins. Just skip the fish. Wasn't there something? Oh, no. I gotta swear there's something in one of these pipes. Let me just check these real quick. No? You go that... Split up bloopers. No? I could've swore that there was a pipe. Well, there's some pipe in this level that takes you to a secret. So that was kind of a failed attempt at the level since I was backtracking and whatnot, so let's just do this for real this time. And speedrun this sucker. This time hopefully I won't miss the pipe, that would be kind of weird. And I still kind of missed it, but whatever. And looks like I'm gonna have to swim through the fishy obstacles normally this time because I don't have my fire flower. But that's okay, it's best usually to show how to get through the stage a normal way rather than just using items to plow through it. So let's just stay low so as to let the bloopers and... What the heck? And let the blooper beep. Oh, come on! Babies, go on without you. Yeah, usually staying low there is the best course of action, but I'm just failing. This level isn't that hard either. So, well, I guess it's, I mean, I'm making use of all the lives that I accumulated there. Strangely, one of the parts someone even mentioned, I only got like one life in the part, which is pretty rare for this game. I mean, this game gives out lives, as I said, like candy. And... yeah, they give out lives through points. Why did I do that? They give you lives through points, through coins, lives themselves. It's just a whole bouquet of lives. If I stay close to the ceiling, I should avoid that blooper. I really don't want to go too low at that point because I have to go up anyway. Yeah! Oh, and of course, if you don't know how to avoid bloopers, if you're like in a group of bloopers, well, there's the midpoint. Ah! Anyway, if you're in a group of bloopers, they cannot touch the ground. Like, they cannot touch one square to the ground, so you can always avoid them touching you if you're just sitting on the ground, or ducking on the ground if you're Big Mario. So that's a simple way to avoid them. Can I go in this yellow pipe, please? Yes, I can! Was that the pipe that I was thinking of? Oh, no! Oh, no! He kills you in one hit if he eats you. He's kind of like a boss bass. I don't think he is a boss bass, though. Well, maybe he is a boss bass. He does have a boss bass shape. Can I kill you with fireballs? Yes, I can. 3 1-ups for killing you! Wow! I also got a star. That was from the other block, of course, but not from killing him. What's in these blocks, anyway? I don't really care about going on ahead with my star power. Just some coins. That was not worth it. I should have went on ahead with my star power. And you're going down. There we go. That pipe was completely useless in terms of star coins. If you hit that, it makes these pipes stop producing a current. Why there was a current coming from those pipes, I don't know. Oh, I bet you that was the pipe I was supposed to go in while the currents were down. I can't go back in there now, can I? I'm gonna have to come back. Boopers! Unless that switch respawns, but I highly doubt it. Yeah, I'll be back here later for that other coin, which is probably the first coin of the level. Unless I can reset this somehow without dying, which is not, you know, ideal to die to reset the whole level. And I don't need that whatsoever. And for some reason, there's coins and bubbles. Some pirate ship must have sunk or something like that. There's a lot of gas in the treasure chests. Everyone should give your treasure chests gas X if you can. Can I get down there for... I'm not gonna be able to get down there, am I? Can I? There we go. Breaks through the block. And there's a star. Another star! Man, what's with all these stars? Okay, I'm just gonna run through here. Maybe it's for the blooper infestation or something. I don't know. And where the heck are all the coins here? Well, there's one down there. Is this the second one? Yeah, that's the second one. So that first one must have been in that pipe that I missed getting into. I believe the third one is... I was gonna say not the... It's gotta be down another pipe. Ow. So I'm gonna go back and check those pipes. Just to be sure. Hey, Mario, go down. Avoid the cheap cheeps. I'm taking quite a while on this level because these dang secrets taking forever to find. And I don't really remember because there's so many freaking pipes. Blue pipe? No. Come on, the blue pipe was suspicious as heck. I mean, it's like the only blue pipe in this whole area. Come on, come on. Can I go down that pipe at least? You, go this way. Okay, come on, come on. Can I go in this one? No, come on! Really? Was I supposed to go up that pipe to get the last coin or something? I don't know. But I checked a pretty good amount of those pipes there, if not all of them, that don't have a current, and I can't get inside the ones that have a current, so I'm just gonna move on ahead. I've wasted enough time already, as well as enough hits. So let's go into the pipe and see what's up. I seriously don't remember where that last one is. I'm gonna check this wall here just to be sure. No, okay. Let's go in! I don't remember where the last coin is, but I do remember there being one inside a hidden pipe near the beginning. Nothing up here, dang it. Well, I'll be back in the level in just a bit, after a simple cut. So, I'll see you then. Oh, would you look at that, I made it to 99 lives! And it's only World 4! I should say halfway through World 4. But anyway, yeah, I'm back over here, and I'm going to do the P-Switch to run thingy again. So I'm going to do that, kill off the bloopers, go all the way to that green pipe. I didn't mean to go up there. Or did I? So there's a coin up here, which I can't quite get. I need to be Mini Mario, don't I? I bet you there's a Mini Mario mushroom. Oh! That's what I need. I need to freeze the fish. Ride it up like that, and... Oh, no! And grab the coin, there we go. So that's the first coin, so I didn't have to do that odd P-Switch run thing to get inside the pipe, whatever pipe I thought it was. So where the heck is the last coin, really? I know you can't get inside those pipes, because there's coin number two, so the third coin has got to be after that coin. So let's just... See, you can't get inside these pipes because the current, like, eh! See that? Just can't do it. And what? Oh, there's the last coin. The one wall I didn't check. Well, let's just get... You go over there. Thank you. I was a little scared of that blooper there, so I hesitated. And that's the end of the stage, finally. And may I add that after completing this stage, there is no secret exit. And why didn't I stay up there? I don't know. So, it's just a one exit stage. It splits off into the item house and the next level. I'm not going to really be doing any of those item houses on camera. It just kind of wastes time, in my opinion, since I already showed you how those things work before. So I'm just going to move on and go over to the ghost house. Ooh, it sounds spooky! Ooh, 4-Dash Ghost House. I hope this isn't the one that has, like, the ultra multiple doors. I don't think it is, though. There's a star here. Oh, but I do remember which one this was. There's some coins hidden inside, like, the ceiling here. The ceiling is not... Oops, I didn't mean to grab that. And the ceiling is not solid whatsoever in certain places. Like, I'm gonna ride this one up as high as it can go and see if I can go into the ceiling just to show you. There are some coins in the ceiling somewhere. I don't remember where, though. That's why I'm gonna be checking these. Just go up high enough so... Oh, that one happens to be solid. Of course it's gonna be solid! And there's some booze! Oh no, that's so scary! And there's also some mice. This one goes down, and there's a coin. I thought... There's either a coin or a door down there. At least I thought there was. You stay where you are, thank you. maybe this was the one that I have to bring down for the door or the coin. Because I know there is... There's a secret exit. Oh, there's a door right there. There's a secret exit, 3 coins, and a normal exit. P switch. Must press switch. Come on. This takes forever, actually. It really does. Wait, is there anything? Oh, there is. There is. Let's just go in this door. I'll go in the other door later. I don't really remember the layout of this ghost house. Then again, I say that about a lot of levels and I end up doing well anyway. Mice come from holes like that. See that dug hole off to the side there between those crates? Yeah. Just saying. Oh, spooky mice! Yeah, if you ever kill one, their other ones in their group get spooked and they start running very quickly. I couldn't show that in the other room because they're only, you know, one of them at a time there. Now that there's a bunch of them, I can show that off. Oh, come on! I jumped right on there. wait. I see something. Okay, there's a door over there and a door over here. Wait. Was that another door that I wanted to go into up there? I don't know. Well, there's the regular exit. That's not what I'm looking for, though. I want secret exit plus 3 coins. Well, I'll be back in there anyway in just a minute. So, this is the normal exit. And let's go explore the house for the secret exit. By the way, Mario doesn't have a hat. I forgot how that works. Alright, we're back in the house for the second run. It's just as spooky as ever, even though those goos are incredibly cute, I have to say. So I guess you can't really say something is that cute, you know, is spooky. But it's just a figure of speech, so to speak, and let's go into this store this time. This probably contained one of the missing coins. Come on, there we go. So this is probably coin number one. I'm hoping. This leads to a completely different point of the house. And did you see that boo? He was going all spazzing out because of I was like right in the center of his detection box of, you know, when to move and when not to move. This is a fake door, isn't it? Yep. Okay, I'm looking for... Well, there's the first coin. At least I think it's the first coin. It's just, yeah, hit that. And I'm gonna try that door. I'm pretty sure it's a blank door, though. On you, there we go. I don't want to get hit by the candle holders. Yep, fake door. And anything in there? No, okay. Come on, you come over here. There we go. And over here, please, thank you. And so those go up when anything touches them. Ow! That one goes down. Could that mean that there's a secret down here? Could that mean there's a secret? No! But I am going to leave this boo away from this block to see what's up, or what's down in this case. Nothing? Really? Come on. No door, no coin, it's a ripoff. Hey there, boo. You're very silly, I have to say. Okay, you move up here so I can go under you. Thank you. And there we go. Fake door? Yep. Anything here? There's a fake wall for whatever reason. That seemed kind of pointless. Unless I can get something that's higher. Yeah, no, there's nothing. Unless there's something. Yes, there is something down there. It's a 1-up! Like, I need that 1-up! So, this this leads to the secret exit? Oh, that was coin number 3 that I got before, so... Where the pooper scoopers is the other two coins. Huh. Okay, come over here. Come on. Thank you. And I gotta go back into the house for the third time. Oh, screw it. Just screw the boo. Now I gotta go back into it for a third time. Check out where the last coins are. Okay, so let's take a looks around this place here and see what I could possibly be missing. I'm gonna actually clear out this place of boos. They're kind of annoying, even though they're adorable. Because I could have swore there was a coin in this first area. I could have swore. And there probably is. Just that I'm missing it somewhere. So I'm just gonna check through these blocks here, one at a time. Oh, there is the first coin. Okay. Now, my guess is that the second coin is inside that hidden area that I completely skipped out on accidentally. And, whoa. I was getting a little bit hasty with that mushroom, so... Anyway, let's speedrun this house, and I'm pretty sure I can just go like that. Oh, I missed the P-switch. Well, I was close anyway. If I did a double jump, I could probably hit that, but let's just go through here and go to the next area, run through it, collect the second coin, and... Woo! I'm getting a little hasty. I'm probably going to take a hit because of that. Yep, I call that. I call that. Don't be afraid, little mice. You'll be okay. Okay, what's up here? What is... There's the last coin. And this, I believe, leads to the normal exit. Oh, it's funny. If you ever try to go inside a door that goes back into the house, most of the time, it'll just disappear. But there is one case that'll actually lead to a coin. Anyway, that's it. That's it for this part and the ghost house. Hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one.